So, as I was preparing for this homily this week, I came across a teaching by Saint Teresa of Avila, one of my favorite saints. And it says this: all of our trials and disturbances come from not understanding ourselves. Let me read that again. All of our trials and disturbances come from not understanding ourselves. Isn't that true? So, in the scriptures that we heard, we have Isaiah who gives the prophecy, and Isaiah knows who he is. He has an absolutely clear understanding of who he is and what his mission is. And then we also hear from John the Baptist. And the Baptist knows exactly who he is and what his mission is. And did you notice our psalm passage? Anybody recognize it? It's the song that Mary sings. My soul proclaims the greatness of the Lord. Or better yet, I think the old way we used to say, my soul doth magnify the Lord. That was Mary's mission, to magnify the Lord. Now, so what does that have to do with us? Well, most of you, I hope, most of you over the years have watched the movie It's a Wonderful Life. Who's watched? Who's seen that? Everybody's seen it. It's a great movie. It's one of the great holiday movies ever. Jimmy Stewart, fantastic, right? I mean, Jimmy is awesome. But Jimmy Stewart plays the character of George Bailey. And what do we know about George Bailey? George Bailey, in It's a Wonderful Life, wants to do something big. He wants to do something exceptional. He doesn't want to stay in the little miserable building savings and loan. He wants to see the world. And yet, as the movie goes along, George realizes that the true meaning of his life is to stay where he is and to do good things. Is that not, my sisters and brothers, what God calls every one of us to do? We have too many people thinking that the only way that I can be satisfied is if I'm famous, or I'm rich, or I'm something of this, and blah, 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 blah. But the reality is, it is living a good life. It is treating those around us with honor, compassion, love, forgiveness. That's what living is about. So let's go just briefly talk about Isaiah and John. The great thing about the Isaiah reading is that it is a prophecy that is foretold to us. It gives us what we need to understand, right? Absolutely it does. And what happens? Jesus comes. Jesus is what animates our life. And if we walk away from that, we lose our humanity. We lose that power to love, to hope, to forgive. So, what we need to recognize is that Isaiah is telling us something that happens with Christ. Because the prophecy that he gives is the coming of the Christ. And that's what John wants, the coming of the Christ. Right? Isn't that really what it's about? Isn't that really what we're here for? Jesus returns home to his hometown of Nazareth. And he goes into the synagogue. And they give him a scroll to read. You know what the scroll is? It's Isaiah. The Spirit of the Lord is upon me. And of course they throw him out of the synagogue. Because they know that this is the prophecy of the coming of the Messiah. And what does Jesus say after he reads the scroll? He says this: today, in your hearing, the scriptures